Hello and welcome to the latest episode of What's New with Microsoft 365. I'm Candace.
I'm Vivian.
And I'm Arthur, and this month we have some great updates to share with you.
Like a new support experience in the Teams admin and security and compliance centers.
Planner integration with the Message Center.
3x3 video layout in Microsoft Teams meetings.
And more. So let's get started.
There's a new support experience available in the Teams Admin Center, as well as the Microsoft 365 Security and Compliance Center.
Some of you may already be familiar with the new support experience from the main Microsoft 365 admin portal.
Because of all the positive feedback that was received from the support experience in the main admin portal, the team launched the same improved support experience in the Teams and Security and Compliance Centers.
To check it out, just sign in to either the Teams or Security and Compliance Admin Centers, and then select the Need Help flyout to open the Help pane.
The new support experience lets you search for answers, contact support and open request tickets, and even view any outstanding request tickets that you may have open.
Next up, Planner integration with the Message Center is now available to help you manage and triage your workflow.
In addition to syncing messages between a planner plan and the Message Center, admins can choose which type of messages get synced.
If you're an admin setting up this feature, you must be a member of the planner plan that you're trying to sync to the Message Center.
In order to access this feature, you must be an admin that has access to the Message Center and not just have a reader role. This feature is rolling out now and will roll out to 100% worldwide by the end of June.
So this next feature is especially exciting and one that we know many of you have been wanting to see for a long time.
In Microsoft Teams, the number of visible participants who can be viewed simultaneously in a Teams meeting is now increasing from 4 video feeds to a maximum of 9.
This is an experience that's really optimized for video, which means that people who have their video feed turned on will be displayed on the meeting stage, while those with just audio turned on will be displayed in the lower part of the meeting screen.
One thing to keep in mind is since everyone has different hardware and bandwidth connections, the actual number of video feeds that gets displayed will vary based on everyone's different capabilities.
There's no action required on the admin's part. These changes are now available to everyone. And if you're using Power BI to share reports or specific charts from reports, you can now share them to Teams with the new Share to Teams button.
Senders can direct the recipient's attention to a specific chart in a report or share to an entire team.
To get started, when you're on Power BI, select Share to Teams and type in the team name you'd like to share with.
And that's all for the show today.
To learn more about some of this month's updates, make sure to check out the Microsoft 365 roadmap.
If there's a roadmap idea available for an update we discuss, we put it in the description below.
You can search on that roadmap ID, which will bring up a card with more details and information about that update.
If you have any comments or questions, please let us know down below.
And finally, if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to get notifications about the latest video that comes out from this channel.
Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next month. Bye.
Bye.